Hey, what's up, everyone? It's Mr. Hania here for Human Development. Today, we're going to be talking about socio-emotional development. You guys got some notes for today, and then we're going to have like a little video activity to do. So go ahead, get your notes out, and we will begin. So what we're going to be talking about today is how teenagers develop their identity and how that sort of differs in terms of their thinking and how they interact with peers and parents and things like that. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. First thing you want to notice with this is that teenagers develop a lot of sense of their self-identity, and a lot of times that comes from what scholar Erik Erikson actually had to say, is that teenagers actually spend a lot of their time going through what's like a little identity crisis, and they're basically going after to answer two questions. Those questions are, who am I? And what role do I play? So basically during this time, teenagers are trying to figure out who they are and, you know, what their whole purpose and role is in this whole thing called life. All right. And what we're seeing once again is that imaginary audience in terms of thinking about how they look, what they think about, whether they're being judged. So oftentimes with that imaginary audience, teenagers feel that they are constantly being watched, that, you know, if something is off about them, then they're feeling that everyone else notices it too. So this is why a lot of teenagers are considered to be obsessed with looks. A lot of people think that more teenagers tend to spend a lot more time in the mirror than they did when they were younger and before they went into adolescence. However, according to what we've seen, adolescents tend to often experiment with how they look, and this often includes experimenting with different clothing styles, hairstyles, as well as makeup. So then with that also comes with the outward appearance concerns coming from these physical changes. So as we mentioned, with those physical changes that happen with puberty and things of that nature, oftentimes that concern with outward appearance comes around that same time because your body is changing and you start notice that, hey, I don't look like this person, or I want to look like this person, or I want to fit in, so I will wear this. So a lot of times this is where teenagers start to develop that identity and start experimenting with looks. So another big aspect that comes from this is also family relationships. Now, as adolescents tend to get older, the feelings and opinions hold more weight when they come from peers rather than family members. So when it comes to like certain situations, teenagers are going to be more likely to ask their friends for advice rather than their parents. And so this is often considered to be a natural thing, because during this time, teenagers, one, strive to figure out more of their situations on their own. They strive for independence and they want to figure out how to handle their own situations. Two, they tend to seek more privacy, develop more of their own, you know, it's my life, I want to get this figured out myself. So they'll seek more privacy in trying to handle those situations. And then one of the things that we see is that they tend to be more expressively moody. You know, and that's just one of those things where we saw with like the back of the brain, the amygdala, and being more of an emotional reactivity towards situations. So what we see is that teenagers tend to make a huge strive for self-efficiency. A lot of times teenagers tend to sit back and kind of handle things themselves. You have some that'll handle things head on and they'll say, okay, I got a situation, I'm going to deal with it. You have some that kind of sit back and they may get viewed as lazy, but during this time, a lot of teenagers want to strive to figure out things on their own. So with peer relationships, what you see is a lot of the teenagers are moving more towards simply socializing in order to form connections. So more teenagers will begin to develop comfort with the opposite sex, and then oftentimes will take enjoyment out of just simply talking, gossiping, having conversations, rather than being involved in activities. So when you're in elementary school, you know, you play dodgeball, kickball, you play it on the playground, you make pretend, you play basketball on the blacktop, you do that kind of stuff, and that's how you socialize with other people. But as you get older, you know, you can enjoy conversation with people, and that can provide just as fulfilling of an activity as you would as when you were younger. And then also for guidance, teenagers are encouraged to form positive relationships, and more importantly, diverse positive relationships. So that's one of the key things, is forming those diverse relationships and making sure that they're making those connections, because learning how to because having those diverse relationships at a young age allows you to consider the experiences of people, develop empathy, and once again, you know, just broaden your horizons a little bit. So now what we're going to do is we're going to watch a clip, a music video of Will Smith and DJ Jazzy Jeff back in the day, and there are going to be some questions that go along with it, but it's to a music video called Parents Just Don't Understand. Some of you may be familiar with this. So what I want you to do is go ahead, submit your notes, answer the questions that go along with the video. And, you know, some of this is going to be questions that are directly related to the video. Some are going to be questions that are going to be more about you thinking about, you know, your own experiences with your parents. And then consider the experience that Will is having in relation with his parents, with his mom, and how he handles them. And then kind of consider how that lines up with what you guys deal with today. So here we go. Parents Just Don't Understand.
Just don't understand. I remember one year my mom took me school shopping. It was me, my brother, my mom, oh, my pop, and my little sister all hopped in the car. We headed downtown to the Gallery Mall. My mom started bugging with the clothes she chose. I didn't say nothing at first, I just turned to my nose. She said, "What's wrong? This shirt cost $20. I said, "Mom, this shirt is plaid with a butterfly collar." The next half hour was the same old thing. My mother buying me clothes from 1963, and then she lost her mind and did the ultimate. I asked her for Adidas and she bought me Zips. I said, "Mom, what are you doing? You ruined my rep."
She said, "You're only 16. You don't have a rep yet."
I said, "Mom, let's put these clothes back, please." She said, "No. You go to school to learn, not for a fashion show." I said, "This isn't shine or not. But back the bell bottom Brady Bunch trousers. But if you don't want to, I can live with that. But you gotta put back the double knit reversible slacks." She wasn't in, everything stayed the same. Inevitably, the first day of school came. I thought I could get over. I tried to play safe, but my mom said, "No, no way. Forget it. There was nothing I could do." I tried to relax. I got dressed up in those ancient artifacts. And when I walked into school, it was just as I thought. The kids were cracking up, laughing at the clothes mom bought. I told my mom how my day went. She said, "If they were laughing, you don't need them, cause they're not good friends." For the next 6 hours, I tried to explain to my mom that I was gonna have to go through this about 200 more times. So to you other kids all across